Hi, I'm Phil, an application engineer here at United Electronic Industries. As we detailed in our last video, ARINC-429 is the standard for commercial and transport aircraft. In this video, we'll discuss the specifics of ARINC-429 message transmission and the unique technology UEI has brought to the table to help you accomplish your real-world application goals. Typically, ARINC-429 allows for two standard transmission rates, one at 12.5 kHz and the other at 100 kHz. Based on customer requirements, UEI has added the ability for you to adjust the transmission rates. You can increase each standard rate by 33% or decrease each standard rate by 33%. Next, we'll discuss how to send messages. There are basically two methods, either through a FIFO or using our advanced scheduler. And you can actually use a combination of both. FIFOs are commonly used in software to send messages in a particular order. The UEI 429 I/O board provides you with a 256-word output FIFO. There are actually two modes to the FIFO, paste and non-paste. Paste allows you to control the intermessage timing by using a user-defined clock. Without paste mode, your application simply controls the timing of the transmission. In computing, scheduling is used to coordinate work by using resources other than your application program. The UEI 429 scheduler includes a table that allows up to 256 labels per channel. This scheduler can be started by your application or automatically based on the receipt of a specific label. The UEI scheduler allows you to send multiple messages at different rates per message. It also allows for many real-world scenarios, such as having one or more entries depend upon another entry being transmitted. In other words, a master-slave functionality. Allowing a time delay, such as a countdown of how many scheduler iterations to wait until this particular message is sent. The ability to specify that a message is only to be sent once and never again. The ability to receive a notification that the message was sent so you can update the message if you wish. Let's talk about the FIFO and the scheduler interacting with each other. By default, the FIFO runs at a lower priority than the scheduler. This means that it will only output data when the scheduler is not sending any data. If you're not using the scheduler, the FIFO is the highest priority object in the system, and thus will always be sending messages. The scheduler and FIFO priorities may be interchanged simply by setting one bit in a register. So if you need to interrupt and usurp the scheduler, you can actually make the FIFO the highest priority in the system, have it send X number of commands, and then change it back to have a lower priority than the scheduler and resume. Got a question about this product or any of our other hardware and I/O? Visit our website, send us an email, or give us a call. Our support staff is ready to help you.